dream.
I'm pretty much ready to hate this boy.
Celius was grounded to the waking world with the talisman, but once he destroyed it, he could enter this dreamland.
It's the castle we just visited, but it's repaired.
Through someone else's dream portal safe. Will the prince end up brain-addled if we go through the wrong one?
Let's find out.
How can the three of you follow me? What sort of powers do you have?
We happen to be enchanted with ancient amazing magics.
You're intruding. Get out of my dreams.
Any ideas how we could do that, Your Highness? Didn't think so. As we're in a dream, is the dense, impassable fog a metaphor for something?
Could be repressed memories. Maybe something he can't face.
Or maybe they had a serious gas leak in the castle.
Thank you.
Amadeus and Pontius, help me figure this out.
within a dream.
So what's this lifter metaphor for?
Maybe it means we are plunging down into the dark depths of his consciousness. I'm glad it's the prince's nightmares we have to contend with. It'd be awful if they were mine. There was a terrible old witch I was scared of when I was young. I still have nightmares about her.
Stop! Stop talking about your dreams. It's not safe.
Amadeus. Come to Auntie Gretchen.
By my trousers! What lunacy is this? I made potions, my hair turned white all over. What if it's worse than the last time? What if my hair falls out entirely? What if something else falls off? My toes? What works?
But I prefer to see you bumble about cluelessly. Get to work!
Of course, Auntie, of course. Just please don't drink any potions.
Stop wasting my time, lazy little boy. Bring the pot to a boil!
Of course, Auntie, of course.
Gasly. But wait! Now the cauldron is heating up too much!
Oh, did I just face my fears and complete potions and come through it all stronger? How very well done of me.
My family left me with nothing. No forwarding address, no letter, not even a postcard. They were more worried about the cat than me.
Well, sometimes families are complicated. Wait, where are you going now?
I'll know when I get there.
Is that wise?
Much better than being locked up in the Astral Academy.
But we're on a mission to get you back there.
Ha! What do you care? You so-called heroes are only the wizard's henchmen. And I am done with them like I am done with the three of you.
The prince's dream had given the heroes some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up at the edge of a forest with the pale moon shining on them. They spied a narrow trail leading into the dark forest. In the distance, the nightmare wolves kept howling.
Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle, Prince Celius had broken his dream talisman. To the heroes' surprise,
How can the three of you follow me? What sort of powers do you have?
We happen to be enchanted with ancient amazing magics.
You're intruding. Get out of my dream.
Any ideas how we could do that, Your Highness?
Didn't think so.
Thank you.
Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle, Prince Celia. Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle. Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle. Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle.
So what's this lift a metaphor for?
Maybe it means we are plunging down into the dark depths of his consciousness.
Thank you.
I'm glad it's the prince's nightmares we have to contend with. It'd be awful if they were mine.
Hmm?
There was a terrible old witch I was scared of when I was young. I still have nightmares about her.
Stop! Stop talking about your dreams. It's not safe.
Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruin. Cornered by the heroes in the depths. Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle, Prince Celius had broken his dream talisman. Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle. Thank you.
It's a bit big to carry around all day.
Cornered by the heroes in the depths of the ruined castle, Prince Celius had broken his dream talisman. To the hero's surprise, the young prince then vanished, quite literally. But no one had expected that the heroes would also be swept along by Celius's strange magic.
Little Amadeus, come to Auntie Gretchen.
By my trousers, what lunacy is this?
Getting a puppy next.
Prince's dream had given the heroes some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up at the edge of a forest with the pale moon shining on them. They spied a narrow trail leading into the dark forest. In the distance, the nightmare wolves kept howling. Thank you.
about we let the boy run? It's his life. And it's not like we're getting anything out of this little field trip, except a pat on the back from the wizards.
Leave the boy alone? In a nighttime forest full of nightmares?
And what if some innocent bystanders run into those monsters?
Glowy stones!
Must be some kind of ancient magic lingering in these ruins.
Let's see what this magic can do.
Thank you.
witch Amadeus was so scared of. She reminds me of someone.
You don't say.
Oh, I really can't put my finger on who it was.
Amadeus, how is Margaret?
Oh, the usual. Business is booming, I hear.
The Prince's Dream.
Thank you.
It seems irreparable. Too bad. Interesting moths in this forest.
That thing up there, that was no moth.
Oh, this forest must be enchanted.
Amadeus, let's solve this puzzle together.
Manages to conjure up all our nightmares.
Then we'll face them like we did with your ma, Aunt Gretchen.
The prince can't conjure a single creature that can scare me.
and the wizard can handle this.
About a box.
And maybe some rope. And an ice arrow.
Oh, good thinking, you two.
Anyone help me? Someone's in trouble.
The heroes followed the distant cry of help. It sounded like a... The prince's dream had given the heroes some... The prince's dream had given the heroes some insight to what was troubling young Sel.
Interesting moths in this forest.
That thing up there, that was no moth.
Oh, this forest must be enchanted.
Well, well.
The prince's dream had given the heroes some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream
you
do like romantic candlelight.
The prince's dream had given the hero some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up at the edge of a forest with the pale moon shining on them. The prince's dream had given the hero some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up at the edge of a forest with the pale moon shining on them. The prince's dream had given the hero some insight to what was troubling young Celius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up.
The heroes followed the distant cry of help. It sounded like a friendly denizen of the forest in need of assistance.
There's no more shouting. I hope they're all right up there.
Let's get out of this cave and see what's going on.
My money's on more nightmares.
Oh, my goodness! My nightmares came to life and ran me out of my house. The only thing I'm worried about is my research journal. Could you heroes please recover it for me?
I'd like a favor in return for this, but I'm not holding my breath.
Zoya, your clever tricks would be good now.
Thank you.
house is wrecked!
Dreams of evil hedgehogs?
Well, I can be a bit prickly.
I suppose we all have our quirks when it comes to our subconscious.
I write to you on behalf of the Astral Academy Library Press. We would like to publish a Badger's Journal of Natural History. From your earlier letter, we understand you've completed your manuscript. Please submit it to us as soon as possible. Thank you. Zoya had an idea of what had to be done. Luckily, Zoya's very handy rope would help the heroes along. Luckily, Zoya's very handy rope would help the heroes along. I write to you on behalf of the Astral Academy Library Press. We would like to publish a Badger's Journal of Natural History. From your earlier letter, we understand you've completed your manuscript. I write to you on behalf of the Astral Academy Library Press. We would like to publish a Badger's Journal of Natural History. From your earlier letter, we understand you've completed your manuscript. Please submit it to us as soon as possible. Thank you.
Lovely goodness.
Now, we don't want to resort to thievery, do we?
You might. I was only appreciating Mr. Badger's good taste in pies.
We can't trust Prince Celius to take care of his nightmares on his own. Not while he can't control his powers.
And too bad his talisman was shattered. Not a lot we three can do to contain him.
What if he magics up every nightmare of every single creature in these forests?
The nightmares really went all the way hiding this journal.
Well, it wouldn't be much of a nightmare, more of a mild disturbance if they'd hidden it in the cave next door.
But we're not afraid of dark holes in the ground. So let's find that journal.
Ah! usually leave my spare key under a gnome somewhere in the garden.
Badger's Journal.
Seems like it's a book on natural history.
Thank you.
Seems like it's meant to support something.
Thank you.
my journal. Thank you. While you were down there, a little bird tweeted that my no-good neighbor is having trouble as well. I think the Nightmare Prince went his way.
The heroes continued their pursuit of the Nightmare Prince, but the trail was growing cold, and there was no prince to be found. In the glow of the late morning sun, the heroes stumbled upon a birch grove, where more nightmares were working their mischief.
At least Celius chose to run off into a more welcoming.
Heroes followed the distant cry of help. It sounded like a friendly denizen of the...
This must be the kitchen. Look at all the lovely goodness.
Now, we don't want to resort to thievery, do we?
You might. I was only appreciating Mr. Badger's good taste in pies.
Heroes followed the distant cry of help. It sounded like a friendly denizen of the forest in need of assistance.
Oh! beauty!
Heroes followed the distant cry of help. It sounded... Heroes followed the distant cry of help. The heroes continued their pursuit of the Nightmare Prince, but the trail was growing cold, and there was no prince to be found. In the glow of the late morning sun, the heroes stumbled upon a birch grove, where more nightmares were working their mischief.
At least Celius chose to run off into a more welcoming part of these woods.